This is Hopped Up. Season's greetings again, Tucson. It looks like you asked for another new brewery again this year. Well, it's about 10:55, so we're gonna head into 10:55 Brewing. We were supposed to take this ring to Mount Doom, but we don't have time for that. JP and Chris. So, what do you guys do here?
I'm head brewer, and Chris is
general manager and head mopper.
So you're a mopologist.
I am a mopologist.
So what made you guys want to start making beer?
Chris has always been a craftsman. He started making beer and I was living up in Phoenix. And he's like, hey man, you should make beer. And I was like, yeah, that's something I should do. And I made my first batch was a rye pale. It was really good. My second batch was a 90-minute clone. We started brewing like crazy. We made some really bad beers. Kiwi whip. Don't ever make a kiwi whip. We won some awards and I fell in love with it. And I had to open a brewery. I think Tucson is a great market. There's a lot of potential for the next 15 years of beer really taking off here.
And so why is your brewery called 55?
It's a homage to my brother. His initials are MLV, and in Roman numerals, that's 1,055. And he brought us together as friends. He passed away 5 years ago, and he lives on in our memory and here.
Here.
So let's talk a little bit about the beers that you guys have here. We're drinking the Leap Pale Ale, and what goes into this tasty, delicious concoction?
Highlights Citra hops. I'm a big Citra fan. Same with our Tucson's Double IPA. And it's got Chinook as a backbone to get some bitterness, and Citra to round it out. It also uses Maris Otter grains. It's a UK two-row grain, which gives it a nice, round, malty, biscuity profile. It took 23 recipes to nail that one down.
23, third time is the charm.
Yeah.
What's the other time tap here right now?
Drinking the Lazy Duck right now, and this one's very much a summer beer, crisp and lighter, and so we call it an American wheat.
Sugar Skull's coming up. We've got that fermenting right now.
Nice.
It's a chocolate milk stout. It's not that heavy. Yeah, so it does have a little body, but it's not gonna weigh you down. You know?
Yeah.
In addition to the lactose that makes it a chocolate milk stout, it's also got some vanilla bean, some Tahitian vanilla, and some Ecuadorian cocoa nibs in there too. So there's a lot of cool flavors going on in that. We're double IPA. So that one, we talked a little about the Citra hop that you find in the pale ale.
Mm-hmm.
The Tucson Citra is only, it's a single hop beer. It's only that Citra hop. So you get lots of citrusy, bright, clean finishes to it. Still got a little sweetness from the malt side, but that one is stellar. 8.5% on that one. So that one's got a little kick to it.
Looking forward to that one.
Yeah.
What was your kind of gateway beer? Something that really got you into craft beer?
So for me, and I've had it a couple times since then, but it's Dogfish's Red and White. Mm-hmm. And so it's this Belgian white ale that they mix with, they actually age it in Pinot Noir barrels, and it's got, I think it's 15 or 16% by volume is actually unfermented wine, unfermented Pinot Noir juice. And the first time I had that, I was like, I didn't know beer could do that, you know?
Yeah.
The flavor that comes with that, I mean, it's got this, you know, obviously the grapes, I mean, the fruit flavor on the back of it was just unreal. And so from there, I started trying other things, you know, with lots of hops and then with lots of oak and that kind of thing. That really expanded my horizons, you know, what I found beer could do.
My gateway was Fat Tire.
Yeah.
It's a staple. And when I first started drinking that, my brother made fun of me for being a college kid. I don't understand what that meant.
I was like, I'm in college.
Yeah, you're in college.
I know.
What's the best and worst decision you guys have ever had while having a beer?
I mean, yeah, we talk about that. I think it's probably the same. I mean, the brewery was formed, you know, after a night of drinking on my back patio, and that was probably the best decision we've ever made. So that's my answer. It's both best and worst has been to open the brewery.
We should open a brewery.
Just like that, yeah.
If you guys could drink any beer with any famous person that are alive, who'd you drink a beer with and what kind of beer would you drink?
So for me, it would be a 90-minute with Sam from Dogfish. Always been a big Sam fan and a big Dogfish fan because of that, so it would be really cool.
Do you think if you had enough beer with him, you could get him to reenact some Point Break stuff? Get Keanu Reeves in this?
Worth a try.
Yeah. So Chris, what do you have for us?
I mean, we were both talking about industry guys. I think Jim Cook from Sam Adams from Boston Beer Company, he's done a lot for, I mean, not just his company, but for craft brewing overall, you know. And they, each year they get bigger and bigger, but they're still putting out, you know, really unique styles, you know, their double IPAs, all their barrel aged stuff.
Sure.
And so I think he's done a lot to pave the way for smaller brewers like us. So that's pretty exciting.
What would you drink with him?
What would I drink with him? Let's see. I mean, so the token answer is Utopias, because that's, you know, obviously super hard to get, and I'm sure he could get me some. But
he might know a guy.
Sure, he might know a guy. But let's see. But my favorite, actually, you know, my favorite Boston beer, Sam Adams beer, is the Imperial White, and that one is just delicious. That's one of my favorites. So that's probably what I would have with him.
It's become precious to me.
The process as well. So it's hard to.
Ridiculous. Anyway, it's a good time at 10:55. Man, that Leapfrog Pale Ale. Tasty, tasty. Any indication, I can't wait to have that Tucson Citra Double IPA. It's gonna be good. And then don't forget about that chocolate milk stout, the sugar skull. Man, it's good stuff, good stuff. Well, since there aren't any cabs down here, I'm just gonna walk home. I'll see you guys later.